Gardeners and nurserymen have taken advantage of certain plants' ability to reproduce vegetatively and create plants with desired qualities. For example, plants with flowers of a particular color or shape. They use methods such as cutting, layering, marcotting, budding, and grafting. These are known as artificial methods of vegetative propagation. These methods can produce crops with better quality and higher yield, and so generate more profit for the farmer. Today, we will discuss the terms cutting, layering, marcotting, budding, and grafting, and how vegetative reproduction can be achieved by them. Cutting. In the cutting method, the stem of a specific plant is trimmed just below the node. That part then planted in a suitable soil. After some time, the root will sprout from the node and grow to become a new plant. Roots that arise from an organ other than the root of a plant are called adventitious roots. For example, the adventitious root that arises from the stem of a plant. Only some plants can develop these kinds of roots and be propagated using this method. These are sugarcane, tapioca, and oleander. Layering. The other method, like layering, is done by bending down a low branch with a node under the ground. After that, about a 5 cm wide ring of bark made by incising the branch along the stem. The ring section should be completely covered with moist soil, while the rest of the branch is allowed to remain free. The new branch is then trimmed from the parent plant, and it will grow on its own when the roots have developed. Layering can be done on plants such as lime and bougainvillea. Marcotting. Marcotting is a method in which a ring of bark is also removed from the branch. However, in this method, a layer of moist soil is folded around the ringed segment and watered every day to maintain the moisture of the soil. When roots show up, the branch is trimmed and planted. Rambutan and chiku trees readily respond to this method of propagation. Budding and grafting. The other methods are budding and grafting. This method uses a healthy plant with a built-up root system called the stalk. The other part is the scion, a section of the plant that will be propagated. The scion is carefully trimmed, then attached to the stalk so it will grow together. The stalk would absorb the water and break down minerals through its roots and transports them to the developing scion. For such purposes, the scion and the stalk are usually of related species. For example, hibiscus, cherry, and almond. The differences between budding and grafting are: in budding, the bud, together with cambium, is taken from a selected plant. This became the scion. Then, a T-shaped cut is made in the bark to the cambium in the stalk. The scion is carefully embedded with the bud, still uncovered underneath the bark of the stalk. The thin cambium in the scion is presently in contact with the cambium of the stalk. The scion and stalk are combined together, and the junction protected with wax. The tissues of the two plants can soon unite, and bud grows into a shoot. Examples of this budding are lemon and hibiscus. In grafting, a twig bearing some buds is trimmed to be used as the scion. The lower part of the scion is trimmed into a V-shape and inserted into the complementary shape of the stalk. The two are tied as in budding method, and buds will then develop into shoots.